In a country so rich in wrestling history, on behalf of World Wrestling Entertainment, it is my honor and privilege to announce for the first time ever, World Wrestling Entertainment will be producing its television shows Raw and SmackDown right here from Japan.
I am excited to come in February to deliver some Stratisfaction.
I think it's going to be truly amazing when the millions of fans that we have all across the world tune into Monday Night Raw and see that we are in Tokyo in an arena filled with thousands of our Japanese fans.
You are some of the most appreciative, the most wonderful fans that we in the WWE could ever have. We want the entire world to know that. Thank you all very much.
Well, there'll be nothing pretty about this when Batista goes one-on-one with Randy Orton to determine who the number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship is.
Oh, this is going to be a test of wills because both of those men were battered head-to-toe after last night. It's going to be something, and it's going to happen live tonight.
The WrestleMania Recall, sponsored by New Clearasil for Men, the official grooming products of WrestleMania 21.
You know, I left tickets for Bill Buckner, but he couldn't bend over to pick them up. How about it?
Speaking of the World Series and the great tradition here in Boston with the Red Sox.
The City of Losers!
Hellfire and Brimstone personified!
And if I were Pete Rose, I might consider heading to the dugout.
Don't worry about Pete, he's tough!
Pete Rose a little bit nervous here, and who can blame him? Pete may think this is fun and games.
Wait a minute! What is he doing?
No! That's Pete Rose! That's Pete Rose! Pete Rose just got tombstone!
I cannot believe it!
WrestleMania will be in Los Angeles at the Staples Center, sold out in record time. And here tonight in Fort Lauderdale, we will find out who the number one contender is.
Will it be Randy Orton Batista? Orton Batista, one-on-one. It's going to be live right here tonight on Raw.
Listen, Dave. Despite all the things that have been said tonight, and despite all this crap that Randy Orton has put in your head, I just want you to know that you have my full support tonight against Randy Orton. You are a member of Evolution, right? And I would consider it an honor to stand in the same ring with you and defend the World Heavyweight Championship. It, not only would it be an honor, you deserve it.
You really mean that?
Yeah, I mean that.
Well, I guess eventually, we all get what we deserve.
Batista, this is going to be a test of will because these two guys were beat to holy hell in that Elimination Chamber match, but tonight they're going to go one-on-one for a chance to face the world champion.
Champ. Triple H.
I've known each other a long time, right?
Yeah.
I'm shooting from the hip.
Yeah.
I do not think Dave bought into what you said out there tonight. I think he's leaning towards Orton. You and I both know we need to have Dave in our camp. We need to motivate him as a unit for that match tonight against Randy Orton, the number one contender's match. He's got to be in here with us. We've got to feel the energy. We've got to pull from each other like we always have.
You know what? You're right. You're right. Batista needs to be motivated. You know what I want you to do?
What?
I want you to go in there.
I knew you'd think of something.
And I want you to tell Batista that up until now, his record against Orton has not been stellar. You go remind him of that.
I'll do it. That's great. That's great.
Yeah.
Wait. You want me to go out there and tell Batista that his record against Orton has not been good?
Yeah.
You think that'll motivate him?
Yeah. Trust me. Batista's big on negative reinforcement. Just tell him.
You sure?
Yeah. Positive.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Okay. Done. Done.
Count on you, Mitch.
Champ, how'd it go? Champ, it did not go well. It did not go well. Batista did not respond to that type of motivational speech. He did not like it. I mean, he is not in a good mood. I mean, he almost tore my head off out there. He might have powerbombed me in a cement hall. It did not fly. I mean, there is some question in his mind, Champ, I'm talking to you. There is some question in his mind right now as to whether you and I are actually supporting him tonight.
What?
I mean, we are supporting him, aren't we?
Yeah.
I told him that. I said, Dave, absolutely, the champ and I are supporting him.
Of course we're supporting him. And you know what? I'm so tired of everybody questioning this. We are evolution. We are a team. We are a team. People questioning whether I support Batista. Of course I support Batista. You know what? I support Batista. And I'm going to prove that I support Batista tonight.
WWE SmackDown Magazine presents the SmackDown Rebound.
You know I'm not afraid of The Undertaker.
Right, I know.
I'm not afraid of anything, anybody. It's just that casket.
There's so much on the line for Heidenreich when he teams with Paul Heyman in a handicap match against The Undertaker. If Heidenreich wins, he gets to change the stipulation in his match versus Undertaker at the Royal Rumble.
Oh, yeah.
Heyman is scared to death. Look at him.
Yeah, Heyman is scared to death. I don't think he walks the part of The Undertaker, and I don't blame him.
In this matchup, The Undertaker has nothing to lose. For Heidenreich, it's all on the line.
Heidenreich's not afraid at all, Cole, but
Heidenreich is afraid of just one thing, and that being a casket.
Undertaker,
balance with that! Oh, and there's old school.
Heyman's frozen in that corner. Man, what's he doing? What's Undertaker? The hell is this? What is he doing? It's a casket, Cole.
Did I just see double?
Dennis, there's two caskets.
These caskets approaching the ring, and Heidenreich is about to go ballistic. And Heidenreich may be looking at his fate come the Royal Rumble.
There's a tag.
Heidenreich just tagged Heyman in. And Paul Heyman will not let his client go. And Heidenreich's got enough of this.